Hi students, how are you all? This is Shravanti. You are watching MathsVaryu. So I am uploading some videos for engineering BSc and MSc students for higher mathematics, which are helpful for your theory and practical or for competitive exams also. So now I am here with another topic in the ring theory, that is lecture 2, that is zero devices. In the previous lecture, lecture 1, just we have discussed only about what is a ring and small example of ring. So in coming videos, I am going to explain more and more examples and difference between what is Z5, Z6, Z modulo, addition modulo, multiplication modulo, which are most helpful for you. Okay, so now in this lecture I am going to explain zero devices. And yesterday in the previous lecture we discussed ring and some types of ring. How many types of rings are there? Two types of ring, that is one is commutative ring and ring with unity. So both, right? And here another special types of rings, nothing but the zero devices. There are some two types, nothing but ring with the zero devices and ring without zero devices, right? So now let's discuss here. There are two types here. The first one is ring with zero devices is nothing but zero devices, right? And the second one is ring without zero devices. So these are the two types. So now we can say that special types of ring. These are special types of rings. These are special types of ring. So here we have two: ring with zero devices and ring without zero devices. Let's see the example first definition, and after that what is the difference, and let's see some examples also. So now coming to here, ring with zero devices. So now what is that means? You have to take R. R is a ring. Then that R is ring is said to be with zero devices. If you are taking two elements from R, then the both are non-zero elements, right? Both are non-zero elements. I am discussing about a ring with zero devices. R is a ring. R is not a non-empty set. It is a ring. Means it satisfies all the three conditions of ring property. And that R is said to be with zero devices. And R ki zero devices unnai ante, you have to take two elements A comma B from R, and that both are non-zero element such that their product should be is equals to zero. If you are taking two non-zero elements from R, you're taking two non-zero from R and you are doing the production or multiplication, right? And that resultant should be zero. Then you can say that this R is with zero devices, right? Got my point? So R is a ring and that R is said to be with zero devices. If two elements are taken from R and the two elements are non-zero elements, but the product is equal to zero with the binary operation is multiplication. So this is with zero devices. Let's take talk about ring without zero devices. So let's take R be a ring, same here. Then R be a ring, comma, then R is said to be without zero devices. If take two elements from R, let us take two elements from R, then the product is zero, then their product is zero, either A equal to zero or B equal to zero. Got the point? Here, ring without zero devices, R is a ring and R is said to be ring without zero devices. If you are taking two elements from R and the product is zero, either A equal to zero or B equal to zero. Either edo okati ronditlo edo okati zero gone. That is, you can say clearly here, if AB equal to zero, the product is equal to zero, either A equal to zero or B not equal to zero. Or you can say that is A not equal to zero or B is equals to zero. You can say these conditions also. So this is known as ring without zero devices. So now you have to remember, ring with zero devices means two non-empty non-empty, non-zero, sorry, non-zero elements, the product is zero. If ring without zero divisors, product is zero, either A or B is either zero. Edo okati zero avali. So this is about ring with zero divisors and ring without zero divisors. Let's see an example, then it will be clear for you. So now here, just only let's clean up and let's see the example here. So for that, first I will write again the condition. A not equal to 0, B not equal to 0 is equal to AB equal to 0. Here the condition is if AB equal to 0, either A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. This is the condition. So let us take an example here. I want to take the example. Let us take Z6. So how many elements will be there? 6 elements, which starts from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let Z6 with respect to plus and addition and multiplication, it is a ring. Got it? So Z6 is a ring which satisfies the three conditions. Now you have to check. I'm not clearing that whether it is 0 or without 0. Now you have to do. You have to check whether the Z6, it is a ring, it is with zero divisors or without zero divisors. Then how to check? Let us take any two non-zero elements from Z6. That is the first condition, right? So to check whether it is zero divisor or without zero divisor, first you have to take some any two elements from this ring. So already we are taking ring, considering ring as Z6. How many elements are there in Z6? 5 elements. So from that 5 elements only you have to take any two non-zero elements. Got the point? Ichina Z6 lo nunche any elements ichcharu dantlo nunchi oka rendu elements pick up cheskondi. First of all, so I want to take 2, 3 r belongs to R, where a, b belongs to R, right? So that two elements should be non zero, and we know that 2 is a non zero element and 3 is a non zero element which belongs to Z6. Here R is nothing but Z6. Then you have to do the product here. Let's do the product. Product means multiplication. 2 3s are under multiplication modulo 6. What is 2 3s are? It is 6. Under multiplication modulo 6, it gives 0. Yes, you have taken two non-zero elements. Then the product is 0. Then you can say that it is with the 0 divisors. Therefore, Z6 is a ring with zero divisors. In this way you have to check whether the given ring is zero or zero divisors or a non-zero divisors. Let's go for the example of without zero divisors. So I want to take the example of set of integers. You know Z is nothing but set of integers, which also includes 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus, these are all integers. So now what you have to take? First you have becomes product equal to 0. For that you have to take two elements. So I want to take two elements, 3, 0, which belongs to Z, right? So then the product should be equal to 0. Then do the product. 3 × 0 is equal to 0. Either any of the elements should be 0. Either A here, you consider A equal to 3. If you consider B equal to 0, either here what? A equal to 3 or B equal to 0. Yes, then Z is nothing but it is a ring without zero divisors. So in this way, what happens for checking without zero divisors? You are taking two elements, then the product is equal to 0. And the product equal to 0, edo okati ganaka meeku 0 element aipothe, then it is without zero divisors. So now this is example of with zero divisors, where the product should be equal to 0 for non-zero elements. For this, well, let's check for another example for matrix, right? Let us talk about the matrices. Let us consider matrix M of 2 cross 2 matrices, which are non-zero matrices. So now what I'm take, you have to take matrix A and you have to take matrix B of order 2 cross 2, and the both matrix A and B are non-zero. Got the point? You have to take two non-zero matrix. So I want to consider matrix A equal to 1 0 0 0, which is non-zero, right? Because the element 1 is there. So next I am considering B here, which is also non-zero. You can write anywhere 0, 1. So this is A which is not equal to 0 and considering B which is not equal to 0. So now what happens to check whether, so obviously you can decide if both are non-zero, then the product should, if it product is equal to 0, then it is without, with 0 divisors, product is 0. If product is 0, either is 0, then it is a 0 without 0. Here obviously you can see by question only, this is a non-zero and this is not. But let's see the product here, A dot B equal to, if you multiply the both things, what happens, 0, it is 0. This is 0 and this is 0 and 0 in 1, 0. So 0, 0, 0, 0. Therefore, AB equal to 0. Then you can decide that if you take any two non-zero matrices, then the product is equal to 0. Then this matrix is of a ring with 0 divisors. So in this way, you can decide for any given ring that give has 0 divisors or without 0 divisors. And conclude just go to. So, avidanga miru. Z6 గురించి Z6 ఒక ఎలిమెంట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చూసారు విత్ జీరో డివైజెస్ ఇది ఈ రెండు స్పెషల్ టైప్స్ ఇవి చాలా చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్ సో మెనీ స్టూడెంట్స్ విల్ గెట్ కన్ఫ్యూజ్డ్ వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ జీరో డివైజర్ ఆర్ వితౌట్ జీరో డివైజెస్ హౌ టు చెక్ సో దిస్ ఈస్ ఎ సింపుల్ వే అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఈజీ వే టు అండర్స్టాండ్ సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద కండిషన్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిమెంబర్ ఫర్ ఎవర్ సో రైట్ సో హియర్ అండ్ ద సే సిమిలర్ ఈస్ ద బోత్ ప్రోడక్ట్ ఆర్ జీరో ఆర్ ఎల్స్ యూ కెన్ సే హియర్ సింప్లీ If the elements which are having zero divisors other than are all without zero divisors. And evaithe meeku elements itla product cheste zero divisors ayyayo. Meeta ante zero divisors kaani vanni kuda elements without zero divisors. Adi ela check cheyachu. Then I will discuss this thing in the next video. So I will take some two rings. Then I will compare. So for example, if I take Z5 and I will take Z6, not this class, in the next class specially, I will discuss the addition modulo and multiplication modulo for Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5 like this. And then let's check that ring. It becomes ring or not. Then whether it has zero divisors or without zero divisors, which will help you very, 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 very helpful for you. So now up to here. You have completed zero and without zero divisors with example. Let's see another special type of ring which is nothing but the Boolean ring. Now let's see Boolean ring. Now let's discuss about the another ring that is Boolean ring. So what is known as Boolean ring means first listen all of you. The R, the ring R comma plus comma dot is said to be Boolean ring if all the elements in R said to be idempotent. మీరు తీసుకున్న రింగ్లో ఉన్న ఎలిమెంట్స్ అన్నీ కూడా ఏం కావాలి ఐడోంపోర్టెంట్ ప్రాపర్టీ అండ్ ఐడోంపోర్టెంట్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ అయితే అండ్ దాట్ రింగ్ ఈజ్ నోన్ యాజ్ ద బూలియన్ రింగ్ ఇఫ్ ఆర్ కామా రైట్ హియర్ ఇఫ్ ఆర్ కామా ప్లస్ కామా డాట్ ఈజ్ ఎ రింగ్ అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సెడ్ టు బి బూలియన్ రింగ్ ఇఫ్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ If all the elements in R should be idempotent elements. Idempotent condition is what? That is A square equal to A for all A belongs to R. So if this condition is satisfied, then you can say that the given ring is an Boolean ring. Let's see an example, then it will clear for you. So first, before going to check whether it is with zero divisors, without zero divisors, Boolean ring, that R should be ring. You have to remember that. So now let us take an example which is small, simple. If I taking the set 0 comma 1, I'm saying this is a Boolean ring. Boolean ring with the ordinary operation or ordinary, you can say composition. Somebody say composition, somebody say operation, it's not a match. So now plus and operation is dot. So what I'm saying, I'm taking them some set 0 comma 1. I'm saying that this is a Boolean ring. How we can decide whether it is a Boolean ring or not? Since the condition should be satisfied. Boolean ring means in that ring, if I take this is R, so in that every element should be idempotent. Means the condition is this. So if your condition is this, means you can apply here. If two elements are there, the condition means if you write 0 square equal to 0, 1 square equal to 1. Yes, the condition is satisfied. If the condition is satisfied, the element is known as Boolean ring. If in that set all elements are idempotent, then you can say that that ring is known as a Boolean ring. So in this way, you can conclude whether the given set is Boolean ring or not by checking all the elements by this condition. So in this way, in this lecture, we have completed ring with the zero divisors, ring without zero divisors, and Boolean ring, so which are important. So in the next video, I'm going to discuss about the integral domain, which is very important for you in anywhere in the topic of abstract algebra. So integral domain with examples, and after that we'll discuss the what are that addition modulo, multiplication modulo, whether it is integral domain with the zero divisors, integral domain without zero divisors, which are very helpful for you. So please for that watch my previous and other videos also, and share my videos to your sisters, anyone who are studying BSc, MSc standards, it may be helpful for them. So thank you for watching. Bye.